What is up, fellow bench warmers? Welcome to Courtside DFS, your daily dose of fantasy DFS with me, JJT, and Kumish. Kumish, dami nag-hit today sa mga picks mo, no? Let's start off, Steph. Yun ang 65.6 fantasy points. Yan yung top play, no? Kristaps, nabanggit din yan. Evan Mobley, nabanggit din natin yan.
Eddie. Josh and Jaden.
Yeah. Oo, Josh and Jaden. Tapos si V.
V.
Yan yung top $10 and value play. $10 for 51 fantasy points. So, 6 games lang yan. Tomorrow, 10 games.
So,
tingnan natin. Injuries. Back-to-back muna. Meron ba back-to-back?
Tomorrow, yes. Meron back-to-back. Di ba Memphis, Miami, OKC ang back-to-back tomorrow?
Yan, okay. So, Memphis, Miami, OKC. Tingnan natin kung sino dyan yung potentially pwede mag-rest. Embiid, the controversial Embiid, questionable, versus the Mavs. Giannis, who was out the last game, probable na ngayon. LeBron, questionable. Anthony Davis, and D'Lo, sabay na natin, probable. O, Lillard out na yan. Shea is out. Ay, yeah, out. Hindi pa pala Shea, sure.
Shea was out kanina.
Oo.
As we said, back-to-back to. So, I think he's gonna play tomorrow kasi hindi siya naglaro kanina sa kanila. Which is, siya OKC. Sa Memphis, si Ja Morant, diba? Yan yung sunod na sabihin mo. Out din siya kanina. I think he will, yan, expected to play na siya sa next game nila. So, yan ang kanina.
And then Harden, questionable. So, may injury rin yan si Harden. Tyrese.
Yeah, Tyrese is out. Tyrese out. Yeah. Jimmy Butler is questionable and Laurie. Jimmy, back-to-back din. Pero may neck injury talaga siya. He was probable to play. Naging questionable, naging out. So, I think it's a real injury. So, in a back-to-back, I don't know if enough time for him to recover. So, let's
Markkanen
wait for that.
Markkanen is questionable.
Markkanen is questionable.
Anthony Edwards,
I think
probable naman.
Yeah.
Jalen Brunson, who's been out na rin for a few games, good. Questionable. Still, Carl Anthony Towns, probable naman to play. Chris Middleton, ito. Ito naman magpahinga. Kasi last time siya naglaro eh.
Yeah, Milwaukee is in the first half of a back-to-back. Sila lang yung nasa first half. So, this might be Middleton who will be resting.
Miles Turner is questionable. So, hindi rin natin sure kung maglalaro pa yan. D'Lo, like we said, is probable. Clarkson, I think, still out. Hindi ko natitignan na. Jeremy
out.
Grant, most Jeremy's likely, out. Still out.
Still out. The whole Portland starting five is out.
Keldon.
Keldon is out.
Out.
Sohan is out. Keldon is out.
Vassell.
Yeah.
Is out. Yung Watford. Ito may doubtful. So mukhang hindi pa medyo malabong maglaro. Nurkic out. Simons out. Sexton still out. Sohan still out. Yan. Hindi ko na nilabas yung notes kasi medyo sure tayo out sila. Burks, I think out pa din eh.
Yeah, out pa rin mga yan. Yung mga, basta yung to be clear lang, you know, yung sa San Antonio, yung tatlong forwards. Vassell, Keldon, Sohan. Tapos yung sa Portland, the whole starting five is out. Trenton Watford, possibly doubtful din eh. So possibly even siya rin out din.
Yeah. Okay, so yun na. Yun na yung mga injuries. Medyo madami. Marami uncertainties actually for tomorrow and medyo expected na rin this point of the season yung mga uncertainties dyan. So, baka makapulot tayo ng mga some value plays dyan later on. Over-under Milwaukee, Indiana 238.5. That's expected to be a high scoring game and then the rest is around 234. Maraming 234 eh. So, relatively good games in terms of pace.
Yeah, in terms of pace, relatively okay naman yung mga games.
Okay, so top plays. Luka, daming pula eh.
Daming pula, pero I think Giannis at 56 against Indiana, as long as sana dumikit konti should be okay. Should be a easy matchup relatively sa kanya. Safer in other words. If you want someone na high risk, high reward, can go with Embiid if he plays. I think given na nangyari the last game, no, yung nag-rest siya, if he plays this time, he's gonna really want
niya.
To.
Mapakita niya.
It's important to him. So I think even if it's a tough matchup, Dallas, a little slower pace, I think kaya niya mag-70 tomorrow.
Yeah, Giannis and Embiid, no? Sa 40s, meron bang okay sa 40s yan? Wala rin masyado eh.
Actually, Sabonis is not bad at 45, no? Maganda yung ano na yan for Sabonis. Siya lang yung nakikita kong, well, it's a good matchup for him. So siya lang yung nakikita ko
more. Good matchup until magkatambakan ulit.
Until magkatambakan, which is again another concern. But this is the silly season, so medyo mahirap na rin nating hulaan yon. But magiging tambakan din yan. SGA at 47 versus Detroit. Again, baka hindi nyo puntahan kasi naka-O. Pero I think if you wait enough, I think he's gonna play. And if he's gonna play Detroit, he's gonna want to play well kasi talo sila kanina eh, sa Charlotte eh. So I think easy matchup again for SGA. Again, let's wait for the final ano, let's assume everybody of those 50 and 40s na pinipredict natin maglalaro like Embiid, like Shea. So mga to, pag naglaro lahat, I think I prefer the 40 players than the 50 players kasi may tambakan factor. I think SGA would be one player na pwedeng puntahan tomorrow. Okay.
And then let's move sa 30s. Top end ng 30s, halos wala na, no?
Wala
Halliburton,
na.
Butler, questionable, Lowry, malabo rin. So, DeRozan, medyo struggling. Halos wala ka ng masyadong mapili, eh. DeLavine has been good for the past few games.
And
you're still gonna go with that. Good matchup in terms of pace.
Yeah. If you're gonna make me choose anybody from the 30s, siguro siya na yun. I do like Jaren Jackson also in terms of, well, he's been playing okay naman.
Not ceiling kasi ni Jaren Jackson parang mababa eh.
Okay naman. Okay lang. As I said, if we're gonna force ourselves to choose people from the 30s, siguro itong mga to na yung parang okay lang. No? Okay, pwede mong punta. Pero to be clear, wala ako masyadong gusto dito sa 30s. Wala masyado. Wala akong masyadong gusto dyan sa 30s.
Diddy, Chris Paul?
Wala eh. Hindi ko pipilitin yung sarili ko to go to them. Maybe din Dinwiddie at 30. But if Mikal is 29, so I would probably go to Mikal. I like Dinwiddie. That's also a good value. But if I'm gonna choose one player there, I'm probably gonna go Mikal na lang. Kaya lang hindi ako mag-Dinwiddie. $2 cheaper. And it's a good matchup. Houston, no? Mm. So I think, I don't know bakit mas mababa si Mikal kay Dinwiddie, to be honest. I don't know.
I think Dinwiddie has the assist. Si Mikal kasi more scoring dependent na lately eh.
True, pero as you can see naman with Mikal eh, medyo nag-hit naman eh. And ang ganda ng matchup eh. So, yun, core play natin. For me, si Mikal is one very, very core play for me. SGA, if he plays, Mikal definitely will be a core play for me. Yang dalawang players na yan.
Okay. Sa 20s, pili pa tayo dyan. Jalen Williams sa 27.
If SGA plays, just okay. No, just okay. Medyo mahirap nga actually yung ano natin eh, kasi medyo may uncertainties pa. But okay naman. Okay rin yung 27 ni Jalen. I think okay. It's okay. Nick, at 27
mm-hmm.
against Houston, I think that's a good play. And then, yung favorite natin, actually, Claxton or Kessler, no? Na lagi natin favorite eh, itong si Kessler. Oh. Pero, wala eh. Parang broken record tayo. Lagi natin
itong Kessler, hindi talaga umangat eh, no? Yung value niya, for some odd reasons, 27 lang lagi.
Laging 27, pero kung titingnan mo, wala eh. I mean,
I
the
think at
upside.
this point, pag nasa 30s na siya, mapapaisip ko na ng konti. Like, 30 man lang, 31, di ba?
And this is San Antonio, no? This is San Antonio. So, hindi naman sa hirap yung matchup. So, the blocks, the rebounds, yun pa lang upside niya. Ayun, may San Antonio siya, 37, 44. So, dun pa lang, that's not even considered a good game, no? For him. Pero 37 and 44 siya. I think easily 40 again.
Yeah.
But with upside to go to 50. So, again, sama natin yan. Mikal, Kessler, SGA. Yan na yung mga talagang pupuntahan mo bukas eh. Medyo is already given to you eh. Parang binibigay na na ito. Kunin nyo na. Kunin nyo na itong mga to. Oo.
Sa low 20s, baka meron 20s, pa tayo mapili dito. Si Quickly ulit.
Yeah, Quickly is okay. But I prefer Jaden Ivey. Jaden Ivey at 22 versus OKC. I like that over Quickly. If Jalen Brunson doesn't play, medyo dikit. If Brunson plays, syempre, out na yan. Pero kung hindi maglaro si Brunson, medyo dikit yan. But I would still prefer Ivy. I would still prefer Ivy over etong si Quickly. Because of the matchup, plus the fact na yung Detroit missing some players, no? They had been going to Ivy exclusively to facilitate. No? So I like Ivy.
Okay, doon just na naman checking, nandiyan pa ba ako? Nandito pa ba ako? Narinig
yeah,
ko
yeah,
pa.
Yeah.
Okay.
Narinig
kasi
namin,
for some reason, hindi ko na siya maklik. So, baka nakadata na.
Hindi ba rin na. Let's go on.
Okay,
no?
Let's go. So, 20. So, yun. Jaden Ivey.
Yeah.
Maybe we can move on to the... Wala na sa 21, no? 21, 20.
So, sa 20, Cameron Johnson. Again, Brooklyn. Pwede niyong puntahan yun si Cameron Johnson. So, okay pa rin yan.
Okay.
So, yun lang. Yun lang yung nakikita ko dyan. May mga good place naman dyan.
Silip na tayo sa value, no?
Yeah. Silip tayo sa value. Sa value, mas mahirap today kasi wala pa tayong certainty, no? Kung nawala tayong screen ni JJT.
Nawala yung screen, eh. Pero sige, tuloy mo lang dyan. Silipin mo lang as I sort this out.
Lang. Okay. Yung Keon Johnson, ako na magbabanggit nung ano nila, yung value. Keon Johnson is $11 for Portland. I like that a lot, no? Keon is 11. Yung Portland, syempre doon na naman tayo pupunta. Yung Eubanks, yung Keon, Shaedon Sharp. Shaedon is 17. No? So, if you're gonna make me choose sa kanila, Keon Johnson is my guy over Shaedon. I like Andrew Nembhard. I like him a lot at 16. So, okay, I'm just enumerating yung mga level of values, no? At this point of the silly season, puro values na eh. Keon, Andrew Nembhard, yan yung top 2 ko. Even in our season long, sila yung talagang pinush ko for tomorrow. Sana tumama, no, yung dalawa. Ochai Agbaji is the third at 14.
Mainit din yan.
Mainit. Plus, wala si Lori. Well, questionable. Well, if Lori plays, so, syempre, mawawala yan si Ochai. But I'm assuming he doesn't play. Simone Fontecchio is also questionable. So, baka wala yung mga forwards nila eh. They would need scoring. So I'm looking at him to produce the scoring for them. Ayun. Tapos yung iba natin diyan, I still like may mga okay lang tayo like sila Luke Kennard at 11, no. May mga ganung place na pwedeng puntahan. Depends on sinong lalaro for tomorrow. So
may mga $10 pa tayo diyan.
Ay, kanina yung nabanggit natin sila, ano, $10 eh. 11 pala okay. Si Keon, no? Wala pa masyado akong nakikitang $10. Sila, ano kasi sila, Isaiah Jackson is higher na eh. Is 11. Pero very near na eh. For me, very near na si Isaiah Jackson. Indiana and, sino tong isa? Indiana, San Antonio. No, yan yung mga teams na pwede niyong puntahan. So, I think Isaiah Jackson, 11. Jalen Smith might start. He's $10. If Jalen Smith start, I actually like Jalen Smith over Isaiah Jackson. That's $10.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Si Kita Bates, I like that also. Nabanggit ko rin yan sa season long. I like Kita Bates. It's not $10. I think it's 12 or something. So, isa pa yon. Isa pa si Kita Bates. Medyo natitripan ko na lower end players. So, yun. Medyo based dun sa nabanggit namin, makakabuo na kayo. I think.
Madami-dami na yon. And unfortunately, hindi ko alam kung anong nangyari, but I can access different sites except the Yahoo site. So maybe baka merong
May
problems din with Yahoo.
Yahoo, yes. Baka may problems. But nabanggit naman natin mostly yung mga gusto nating banggitin ng mga value plays. Eh. Yun naman ang importante for them, I guess.
Yeah.
Yung value plays kasi yung mga gusto nilang makita rin yung mga predict natin. If SGA doesn't play, I say a joke. He had what today? I think he had 35, not after 41. Walang SGA, go straight Isaiah Joe versus Detroit. Pasok niyo yan. Pasok niyo si Isaiah Joe. But again, depending on what the status of SGA, I'm just predicting na SGA will play tomorrow. That's my analysis, kumbaga.
All right.
SGA.
So yan na guys, before I get cut off, no, kasi medyo, yan na, nafe-feel ko na.
Ano muna natin? O sige, bago ka ma-cut off, yung season ender natin, umabas na yung ano ha, yung mechanics.
Oh, yan.
Ano na kayo? Season Sports Plus PH.
Mag-start yan April 5. Tama, diba? April 5.
Yes, mag-start yan sa April 5 in coordination with Sports Plus Sports Plus PH na Pagcore license betting site, no? 100% legit. Ito, you have to register with them. With Sports Plus PH, you know, show, tapos parang i-screenshot nyo yung registration para makasali kayo sa raffle portion. Kasi may Air Jordan 1s na ira-raffle. Eh. So, okay. Para makasali kayo doon. And then the price, medyo rin-release na rin ni Max, no? First place is 20,000, second place is 8,000. Free to. Everything is free entry. And then anybody can join, even if yung mga hindi pa marunong, hindi pa nakakasali, lahat. Wala, walang restrictions. So, yeah, sali tayo. Sali tayo.
Okay. All of those you can check sa hof-dfs.com and sa Facebook group as always, Hall of Fame DFS. And sa group chat, sumali kayo doon. And yeah, that's it for today's Courtside DFS. We'll see you guys again tomorrow. Small slate ba tomorrow? Yeah, tomorrow yung small slate. Hindi pala natin sure kung meron tayo kasi two games lang. Yung Friday. So we'll see you when we see you. Maybe Friday. Hopefully umabot tayo. Alright. Bye guys. Have a good day.